Hello everybody, welcome back to Life is Strange. About to start episode 4, Dark Room. Okay, how do we start it? Exit, I don't want to exit the main menu. Continue your story with episode 4. Yes please, how? Available now. But we have it. Continue. What's going on?
Previously on Life is Strange.
Okay.
Whoa. You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Let's talk about your superpower.
What are you doing here, Mac? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us. Miss Caulfield, please, tell us everything.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
Max, we have to find Rachel soon. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues.
Welcome to my domain. Let's find what we want and beat it.
Max, you better come check out these files. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it. Listen, I found pictures of Rachel and Frank. Being more than a friend.
I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
No, you don't.
Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? Ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Hello? Are you even listening, Maxine?
This is totally fucked up. What else have I changed?
Max Caulfield. Hold on. Chloe, you have a visitor.
Right. Let's see what's afoot. Alright, we know about this bloody blah blah blah. Can we skip this bit? Skip, skip, skip. No? We will try and choose wisely. Or choose unwisely. We shall see. Beach, crab, water. Hello. Fixated with this crab. This episode just going to be an intro. We're going to actually do anything. Bicycles. Not chained up. I think next if that's in England. A dead whale. Loads of dead whales, Jesus. About six there, isn't there? There's the lighthouse. Alright, come on. Let's get into the game.
It's weird hanging out with you again.
I know. I'm glad we are, though.
It was nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done. And you even wrote on that cool parchment paper.
It's
so, Max. So pretentious. But I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery.
Probably easier to write than to visit me. I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much, yeah.
Look, the worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop? This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
See? Without you here, I'd have no clue. Bet you could take some amazing shots. Those beached whales are so sad. I kind of know how they feel. At least, I'm alive here with you.
You're a real survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with so much.
I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me. I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
Are you okay to talk about the accident?
We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch.
Do you remember everything?
I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and that was the last thing I ever felt in my body. When I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like that girl from Blackwell.
She's still missing.
You mean Rachel Amber? When was the last time you talked to her?
Never. I just read about her in the news. I didn't even know her name. You did?
This is such a different world than when we were kids, isn't it?
After that snow and eclipse, it's like the end of the world.
You think?
Do you think so? I haven't kept up with the details.
I have more time on my hands than you. Plus, I'm a science nerd. But none of this makes sense.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again. You don't even know.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. That was wrong. You're my best friend.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word, no offense.
None taken.
Sheer. Man. How things have changed. Now what we're gonna do? You don't want her dad to be dead. You don't want her to be in a wheelchair. There's that freaky lighthouse. So where are we now? Back at Chloe's house? At school? Chloe's house by the looks of it.
Pretty high-tech lair.
Feels like a high-tech cell. But I am lucky my parents bust their ass to take care of me. I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you are here with them.
Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me. Pathetic, you know.
Chloe, you're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive. When you don't even have to be.
Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch while I take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science doll.
I can't even imagine. But you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids.
All right,
thanks,
guys.
Thanks for coming, Max.
I'm going to end this video here now. Depressing as it is. Our next episode will show
can you bring me some water?
Carry on. But thank you very much for watching. This is Red Fox, signing out.